Hello and welcome to episode 6 of Unpacking Articles. My name is Florencia Henshaw. I have a PhD in second language acquisition from the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign. And the author of today's article also has a PhD from the same university. Today we're going to be unpacking this research study, training students to use online translators and dictionaries, the impact on second language writing scores. And this is a topic that generates a lot of discussion and debate. Essentially, we all want to know, are online translators helpful tools for language learning? Well, some instructors think it's a helpful tool, but it's a helpful tool for cheating. And other instructors think that online translators are just one more tool. Just like in math classes, you can use calculators. Maybe in language classes, you can use translators. What do we know from previous research? Well, we know that most students use translators often, and they tend to use them to look up words, to look up phrases, double check things for editing. At least that's what they're reporting on surveys. We also know that the percentage of students who report using online dictionaries is similar to the percentage of students who use online translators. As for the impact on the quality of writing, we know that students write better essays, better paragraphs when they're using online tools, and that makes sense because these tools are a form of assistance. That's not the case for all languages. We know that translators are better for some languages than for others. But the big question remains, does the use of online translators and dictionaries impact second language development? What I mean by this is that we already know, we are convinced that online translators and dictionaries can help them write better papers because it's a form of assistance. But what about future writing assignments? Do students who use online translators and dictionaries end up writing better papers in the long run, even when they cannot use those tools? And that's what this study is trying to find out. The participants were 310 college students. They were in third and fourth semester Spanish and French courses, and they were divided into these 5 treatment groups. Now, the author doesn't tell us how many participants ended up in each group, which is a bit unusual. Most research studies do tell you how many participants were in each group. But the groups were one group that was Google Translate, and they also received training on how to use Google Translate, the pros and cons of it, looking at examples, etc. Then you had a Google Translate group, but they did not receive training. And the same for word reference, with training and without training. And there was a control group that did not use any tools. First, everybody did a pretest, which was to write a 3-paragraph letter. And they could not use any tools at all. A week later, everybody did a 20-minute session. The groups that received training, of course, participated in the training that was about the tool they had been assigned, either Google Translate or Word Reference. The other groups that did not receive training attended a 20-minute cultural session. Then, a week later, everybody wrote 2 compositions. And for this part of the study, the groups that were Google Translate groups were allowed to use Google Translate. The groups that were Word Reference groups used Word Reference. And of course, the control group didn't use anything. The point of this part of the study was to collect data to see if training the students on using tools and then asking them to write something using the tools resulted in better essays. The part that's really interesting to me happened 1 week later, and that is the first post-test, for which the students were not allowed to use any tools at all. Once again, a 3-paragraph letter, different topic, but same format, and nobody was able to use any outside tools. 4 to 5 weeks later, they did a delayed post-test, like a second post-test. Again, 3-paragraph letter, different topic. And nobody was able to use any tools at all. So this part of the study is going to help us answer the question of whether using a tool impacts their ability to write unassisted later on. Everything that the students wrote was scored by different raters. They had 12 raters total, because there were a lot of essays. And each composition, each essay, was double rated by 2 people. The raters assigned a total score out of 30 points. For each of these 6 categories, they assigned 5 possible points, and the categories were content, grammar, spelling accent, syntax, vocabulary, and understandability. So, what were the results? Well, for the compositions where the students were able to use tools, the groups that received training did better than the groups that didn't receive training. And also, the Google Translate groups did better than the word reference groups. Now, with respect to the post-test, on the first post-test, the Google Translate Plus training group did worse than all of the other groups. Now, for the second post-test, the delayed post-test, there were no differences among the groups. Everybody did about the same. And I want to point out something that caught my eye as I was looking at the mean scores for all of the compositions and for all of the groups. As you can see here, the Google Translate groups had a spike in scores for the 2 compositions when they were able to use Google Translate. And then they went back to the same levels as the pretest. The other groups, on the other hand, you see that they sort of stay more stable throughout. So this makes me wonder, when the students are using Google Translate, how much is it truly their own ability? And you probably also noticed that the Google Translate Plus training group had the highest and the lowest scores. So why was the Google Translate Plus training group different from the rest? One possibility that the author suggests, and I agree with, is summarized in this quote, and it says, "It is possible that once there was no longer the ability to use Google Translate, students in the Google Translate Plus training group could no longer put their training into use and had become more reliant on the tool they had begun to master." And that last part really resonates with me. Are students essentially mastering the use of a tool, and therefore, is that what we are assessing? As a language educator, I'd like to think that I am assessing their ability to use the target language and not their ability to use Google Translate. Some of the limitations of this study could certainly be overcome by future studies. The first one is that Spanish and French students were all lumped together. Of course, Spanish students wrote in Spanish and French students wrote in French, but the scores were all lumped together. The second limitation is that the study used overall scores, and so future studies should probably look at a more fine-grained assessment so that we can better understand where the differences lie. In this particular case, for example, we don't know if some of those lower scores were due to linguistic issues as opposed to content. Remember that one of the categories that the raters were using was indeed content, to what extent the learners had addressed the prompt. A third limitation is that all of the topics were different, which I understand why. But I can't help but wonder if perhaps asking the learners to write the exact same thing later on could give us more insights in terms of learning gains. For example, if they looked up a word on Word Reference, do they remember that word by the time they have to write the same thing again? So the bottom line is, training is helpful, and I fully agree with that. Now the question is, helpful for what? What I would say is that the study tells me that training is helpful to use a tool, yes. But the question of whether using these tools has an impact on second language development, that remains unclear. And so the takeaway message for me is an analogy that I often used. Google Translate is like a self-driving car. It will get you there even if you don't know how to drive. On the other hand, Word Reference is like a GPS. It will help you get there, but it will not drive for you. And this is why in my classes, I do see a role for tools like Word Reference, but I'm still very much skeptical when it comes to Google Translate as a learning tool. That's just my take on it. As usual, I encourage you to read the article for yourself and draw your own conclusions. Thank you for tuning in, and until next time.